Hey everyone, welcome back to the AI Coffee Break. Today we're giving you a sneak peek into one conversation that happened at the HLF 2024, namely about why people fear math. At the end of the video, you will know what the fear most people have about math has to do with how we judge the intelligence and abilities of today's artificial intelligence systems.
Yeah, so I want to say, I think one of the curses for us, a curse and a blessing. I can say for me, I'm not talented in almost anything. The one thing I know how to do is math, okay? Any other thing, put me in any other context, I'm like a disaster. However, I'm considered very smart because I'm good at math. So immediately, I'm considered super smart. Now, there can be a person talented in so many things, but they're not good at math. They're not, like, often they won't be considered smart. Now, why am I saying it's a curse and a blessing? It's a blessing. It's nice to be considered smart. You know, people think you're smart. Thank you very much. However, the curse is that because that's the case, I think that's why people fear math. People fear math because if you're not good at math, you're considered like you're stupid or something. You know, people become kind of self, hesitant. That's a big problem. I think understanding math is one specific talent among a gazillion others. You can be good in music, you can be good in art, you can be good in literature, you can be good in math. It's one out of a million. And it doesn't say anything about anything else except that whether you have this technical ability or not. First, if we had that understanding, I think people will not be so scared of math. That's the first step. In addition, I think that's the main inhibitor, actually, in my opinion. You know, we have that in Israel with English. If you don't speak English well, you're considered like you're not smart. And then whoever was not trained very early on in the language tend to not talk. Like as soon as people start to, they run away because they're scared of, being judged. That's a problem. And I think that's happening in math. So that's something that our culture needs to change. You know, it's important to understand it says nothing if you're good or not good in math, whatever that even means. Second, I think teaching math well is not easy, especially for older children. Even for younger, they teach it many times in a boring way. And so kids get bored. So I think teaching math well is often more difficult than teaching other. When you read a story, everybody enjoys a story, good story. When you teach art, people draw. There's something more natively easy to do. Math, numbers, it sometimes requires it's a harder task to teach. And I can say more and more how I think it can be taught better, but it's a longer answer. But I think the two obstacles are better teaching and getting rid of the people being scared of being judged because they're not good at math, whatever that means.
Now, you're probably wondering, why are we even talking about people's fear of math on an AI channel? Well, what we just heard from Professor Yael Tauman Kalai is fascinating on its own, but it touched on the abilities of human intelligence with ties in with artificial intelligence. When we assess or measure artificial intelligence, we often fall into similar traps. First, we tend to think of intelligence as kind of a single number or a score, a one-dimensional measure of ability. But intelligence, whether it's human or artificial, is way more complex. It's multidimensional. Someone can be brilliant at math, but struggle to catch a ball, or vice versa. Some abilities might complement each other, while others can actually compete, like exploration versus exploitation. They're so opposing that if you max one out, the other will be at minimum, and you cannot have them both maxed out. So, in the same way that we should value human intelligence across all sorts of abilities, being a talented musician, an incredible athlete, an esports pro, and not only if somebody is a math whiz, we should appreciate AI on each dimension separately too. It might excel in some areas and, fail hard on others. While we may expect for AIs to have better ability coverage compared to humans, remember that it is still impossible to max out the dimensions that are competing, such as exploration and exploitation. The second big takeaway here is that certain things just come easier to humans than others. Picking up a cup of coffee feels natural, but math? It's more alien. It has numbers and objects in it that are so abstract that they don't connect to anything physical all the time. Our ancestors evolved and trained for millions of years to run and climb and throw, but calculating the path of a rocket to Mars, that's very recent history for us. So, there's this tendency to assume that things we find easy must be easy for any intelligent being, human or not, but it might be actually easier to implement the things that we're not good at in AI. Because remember, intelligence has multiple, sometimes orthogonal dimensions. Some things that are hard for us might be easy for AI. For example, the rapid calculations and memory skills needed in arithmetic to hold tons of numbers at once in memory. This is just basic computer stuff these days, not even what we think of as an AI anymore. But you can bet that any ancient Egyptian would have been amazed by a skill like that, probably even calling it divine intelligence. And of course, we've long thought that games where most of us struggle, like chess or Go, were the pinnacle of intelligence, right? At least so we thought until AI solved chess, then Go, and we realized that these games are a good competition between humans because they're tough for us. They demand considering countless possibilities and holding them all in memory, something we're naturally limited in. So games like chess and Go are a good measure of the intelligence dimension where humans do not shine, but not on the other dimensions such as climbing a tree, where any cat would make any AI look stupid in comparison. So, just think about it. Intelligence isn't as straightforward as we might think. Today, we just wanted to give you a quick food for thought to fill your cup on this AI coffee break. Until next time, keep exploring the dimensions of both human and artificial intelligence. This conversation with Professor Yael Tauman Kalai happened at the 11th HLF, which is short for Heidelberg Laureate Forum. The HLF is an annual gathering of 200 young researchers from math and computer science and laureates of the most prestigious awards in these two fields, such as the Turing Award, the Fields Medal, the Abel Prize, and so on. I attend the HLF always with utmost enthusiasm. The best thing for me at the HLF remains the lengthy coffee breaks. See if you can spot me, with enough time to have one-on-ones with laureates and young researchers, and there's enough strong scientific program intermingled with social events at incredible locations such as the Speyer Museum of Technology or the boat on the Neckar River. If you want to be part of the HLF too, just read the info on their website, linked in the description below, and submit your application. Thanks for watching, and to enjoy your coffee breaks with our next videos, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe buttons. Okay, bye.